Dixon-esque blouse. So would have been worn, and she would have had several blouses. Couldn't find the perfect one. I wanted with nice big sleeves. But with a black skirt, she could have had one or two skirts and maybe seven or eight blouses, which would have extended her wardrobe greatly.
Is that cotton?
This is cotton, so off the lingerie style.
So that wouldn't be considered a shirtwaist?
This is a shirtwaist. Yeah. Now, see this band here? It didn't go on the outside,
raise your hand.
The inside of her garment. It did not wear a blouse to the outside.
I'm surprised they didn't make them longer then, but I guess the waist was...
The waist came up high.
So that looks like a crop top.
Just
that looks like a really short top. For like compared to today's shirt waist.
Oh, let's call it 1890s. I mean, that's awfully broad. It's really later, I think. The sleeve isn't very big. In fact, the sleeve is really kind of cool. You see? Because it's raglan style, I'm going to turn it around. No seam. So from the wrist to the wrist, it's one piece of fabric.
Oh, so like a...
So kind of expensive in today's world, because you would put a seam there. But that means the whole length of fabric. And it's on the lengthwise grain, right?